Alright, hey y'all. I'm gonna be doing some XCOM Anywhere Finn. This is the second take. I forgot to enable second wave on the first take. So we're going to be doing XCOM Anywhere Finn with a bit of a twist. Anyone can leave a suggestion in the comments for a soldier name. Just mention their class, and a first name, nickname, last name. In that order. Like, Patrick Polpol Munich is one of them. I'm going to be rolling with some for my Discord server. The damage roulette and not created equally are... Hidden potential and not created equally make it so that soldiers have greatly randomized stats. I like that, yeah. A lot. Gonna be skipping cutscenes, but I will be talking over them a bit. Which is why I have subtitles on.
Of the recent extraterrestrial incursion, this Council of Nations has convened to approve the activation of the XCOM project. You have been chosen to lead this initiative, to oversee our first and last line of defense. Your efforts will have considerable influence on this planet's future. We urge you to keep that in mind as you proceed. Good luck, Commander.
That was the last transmission, sir.
Patch me through to Voodoo 3-1.
You are being deployed to Germany. At 1900 hours Zulu, several unidentified objects fell to Earth. After ruling out the possibility of a downed satellite, we now believe these objects to be extraterrestrial in nature. Shortly after impact, German officials received reports of mass hysteria and freak weather around one of the impact zones. Then things went dark. At 2100 hours, a chopper carrying a German military recon team went down in the area after they reported being fired upon. As you know, Germany is a member of the Council, and they have requested our assistance. Our mission is to assess the situation on the ground, ascertain the current status of the German recon team, and investigate the extraterrestrial objects. Central out.
I hate this tutorial so much.
Looks like we found the crash site.
Roger, Voodoo 3-1. Any sign of activity?
Negative. Nothing's moving down there.
Okay. Set her down nearby.
Central. You getting all this?
Copy that, Delta Squad. First things first, let's get you out of the open and into cover. Whatever did this could still be out there. Delta One, take point. Take cover behind that debris directly in front of you.
Gotcha.
Good. Now advance to the vehicle nearby.
Ah, for God's sake, that's the phone ringing.
Move up to the debris. That thing isn't going to offer you much cover, but it's better than nothing. There's full cover straight ahead. Advance to that position. Delta 3, move to that vehicle dead ahead.
Central, I have movement. 30 meters north of my position. Police vehicle.
Roger. Proceed to the next vehicle for a better vantage point. Delta 4, go check it out. It's a long way from your position, and there's no available cover.
Holy hell.
What do you see, Delta 4? Report.
Looks like one of the recon teams, sir. It looks like something.
Is that your man, Delta 4?
Negative, sir. That's someone else.
Dr. Vollen, what's he saying?
He is saying, help me. That radio transmission is coming from somewhere north of the squad's current position. Based on its strength, probably from inside a structure.
Thank you, Doctor. Delta, advance and infiltrate that building. And remember, stay in cover.
Never do this. This will get you killed. Especially with rookies. The thing to understand about rookies is that rookies suck.
I got a lot of blood here.
Roger. See where it's coming from.
Central. I think I just found another one of the recon team. Or what's left of him. But this doesn't make sense. Looks like he's been dead for a week.
Even more perplexing is the cause of death. It appears that he was eviscerated when something burst out of him from the inside.
Sir, I have visual on the object. Permission to approach.
It's the only cover between you and that building. Permission granted. Talk to me, soldier. What is it?
I got no idea what this thing is, but I can confirm that it's no satellite.
Roger. All right, Delta Squad. You're almost to the building. Keep moving. Okay, people. Now let's get inside. Delta One, there's a window in front of you. Let's take a look.
In position. Looks clear.
Copy that. Get in there and get to cover. Delta 2, that door's in our way. Take it down.
Solid copy.
Central, we have eyes on the target. He's armed.
Copy, Delta 3. Okay, everyone. Get into position nearby, but do not approach. Doctor, see if you can communicate with him. Tell him to drop his weapon.
I will try.
You could move up here, though.
Hallo. Können Sie mich hören? Wir sind hier, um Ihnen zu helfen. Bitte lassen Sie Ihre Waffen fallen. He appears to be in shock.
Keep your eyes open, people. I don't like the looks of this. Delta 3, move in and disarm him.
How do you all suck so much? This is just scripted sequences. And then sectoids.
He's down. Delta One is down.
Doing more damage than they actually can do, because cutscene.
Some better cover. All right, Delta 2. Weapons free. Get ready to fire. Nice shot. Delta 4, you're freed up to move. Get out of there and get into cover. Now toss your grenade at the enemy in front of you. Delta 4, there's another one coming in behind you. Damn it. It's just you now, Delta 2. Let's tip the odds in our favor. Look around for a position where you can flank the enemy.
I've done this.
That's it.
Quite a lot.
A clear shot from that position. Fire.
This is my fifth time total in this XCOM tutorial.
Central, I think that's it. It's over.
And that's the whole reason I did tutorial.
Secure the bodies and head back to the sky.
That guy, right there. That soldier is a heavy. Heavies are your savior early game. We're gonna pick North America. Because I'm not going to try and select something red. Insert communism joke here, hearty har. And Europe's bonus is garbage. So we're going to North America.
Affirmative. We are coming home.
Whatever they are, they nearly took out a squad of our best soldiers. If you'll excuse me, doctors, the commander is waiting in mission control.
Their technology is far beyond ours.
Then I'd say our work is cut out for us, doctor.
Welcome to XCOM HQ, commander. I'm Central Officer Bradford. My role in this project is twofold. Providing tactical support for our field operations, and keeping you briefed on the current situation. My efforts should allow you to focus on the bigger issues at hand. Speaking of which, we have a soldier waiting for a promotion in the barracks. I'll let you get to it.
Commander to the barracks. Commander to the barracks.
Holy crap! That's amazing! Two adjacent steam vents. And another one right there. Crap, I just need to build a pair of geo-generators in the bases. Set forever. Nice.
Commander, the soldier is waiting for you in the armory, which is located there in the barracks. Only one recruit from Delta Squad made it back alive from our last mission, Commander. And I'd say a promotion is in order. As you know, Commander, every soldier is different. This particular soldier has shown an aptitude for heavy weapons. As he gains additional combat experience, we should continue his training along these lines. This soldier will now carry a rocket launcher, in addition to his standard weapon. The aliens won't know what hit him. Oh, Dr. Vollen asked to see you in the research labs, Commander. It sounded important.
Commander, to the research labs.
Hello, Commander. My name is Dr. Farlan. I oversee the research labs. This is where all of XCOM's research and development takes place. We have already begun analyzing the artifacts recovered from our first encounter with the aliens. Based on our preliminary findings, we believe we can use them to develop some new equipment for our soldiers. With your approval, We will begin research immediately.
Alien materials first, because you can easily get one critted.
Thank you, Commander. This research will take some time. We will notify you once it is complete.
Commander to mission control. Commander to
it sounds
control.
Like you are needed elsewhere. Farewell, Commander. If you recover any additional artifacts during your field operations, I would be quite eager to study them.
Commander to mission control.
The enemy is testing our capabilities, Commander. We've gotten reports of simultaneous attacks in two different countries. We can only respond to one. The country we help will donate more resources to our cause. But the panic level of the country we choose not to help will rise. It's not an easy decision, Commander, but it's one you'll have to make.
There's always one in the US and one in China.
Understood. The troops are waiting for you in the hangar.
Commander, before deploying our squad, you can choose which soldiers to send out there. I've taken the liberty of calling up our veteran. His combat experience makes him invaluable on the battlefield.
Okay, so just a quick example, I'm gonna show off some of the customization you can do. Just gonna flick through all the colors. Had to do a double take there, sorry. Now that we're here, I'm going to explain the gimmick of this LP. Taking a cue from Guava Moment, the maniac that he is, I'm going to let all of y'all name the soldiers. I've got a Discord group, the people... I've got some suggestions from there, but anyone who happens to get this in recommended, suggest a soldier name! And maybe suggest a class for them to be. So far I've got an assault, a support, a heavy, two snipers, and a mech. In terms of who's gonna get names and all that jazz. Now we see a typical XCOM mission. This one isn't as scripted as the tutorial. It's still quite stupid, but it's... I don't know.
Strike one. Prepare for landing.
Hold on, soldier. Before you move out, let's see what's inside that building. Your squad mate is closer, so let him check it out.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Gotcha.
Good. Now open the door.
I hate Quiet. These doors so
Don't
much.
Reveal your position to the enemy. Okay. Now take cover inside. Alright. Now I want a man on the roof of that building. See if you can find a way up there, soldier.
He always wants to have his dash up here and sight a parasectoids.
Hostile spot. The rest of you, advance toward the enemy and get into cover. Hold your fire until I give the word.
Can I rush them in here? Yes, I can.
Location confirmed. Roger, Dodger.
Oh! That usually doesn't happen. That's what I like about this stage. Unlike the actual tutorial, Oh god, it wants me to shoot. You gotta be kidding me. Good rule of thumb in XCOM, if you've got a soldier exposed like my heavy is, move other soldiers into position near them so the aliens are less likely to target them.
Damn it.
You know, it's a little thing, but I like that this game bothers rendering casings.
That's affirmative.
That's XCOM, baby! Now that heavy's gonna get critted. That's unusual.
That's affirmative.
Great work out there, people.
The commander will be assuming command now as you sweep the rest of the area. As always, I'll be offering tactical advice as needed. And remember, your armor can only withstand a couple of shots from their weapons, so keep your eyes open and your heads down. Good luck.
Oh, that's the exact opposite of what the game wanted me to do, but it was worth it. Well, it wants me to rocket them. But that, right there, got me extra loot. Because killing enemies with explosives means they won't drop anything. So instead I'm going to exploit prior knowledge to move my soldiers to what I know are decent firing positions.
You're okay, soldier. But another one like that, and that'll be the end of you. Make sure to stay in cover. Commander, a veteran's rocket launcher should make easy work of the structure the aliens are using for cover. And if we're lucky, we can take out the aliens. If it hits. Good work out there, Strike One.
If I may.
Oh. Gonna wrap this up soon. Sorry for skipping that there, just gotta... I'm going to be very busy soon. Weapon frags.
As soon as you give the order, Commander.
Commander, we have an incoming transmission from the Council.
Hello, Commander. We wish to congratulate you on your most recent victory. We realize you were faced with a difficult decision in responding to the various requests for assistance. Regardless, you performed admirably. As agreed upon, the reward for your actions has been granted. Farewell, Commander. We hope that you are met with continued success.
Okay.
The Council knows you made the right decision, Commander. With the resources we have available, there's only so much we can do. However, our chief engineer did come up with something to help you keep an eye on things.
The Situation Room provides constant monitoring of every member nation in the Council. If we allow panic levels to get out of control in any given nation, they're going to withdraw from the Council. Then they'll take their funding and additional support with them. The Council's overall confidence in the XCOM project is shown on the primary meter above the main screen, which engineering has nicknamed the Doom Tracker.
Commander to Mission Control.
Commander, Dr. Vallen reports that research is progressing in the labs, but it will still be some time before the project is complete. While we're waiting, our local satellite network has just come online, and we can now begin scanning for new activity. The process could take several days.
Can I save and quit yet? Because I actually need to go do something soon.
The schematics for the nanofiber...
Commander, with this research complete, my staff and I currently have nothing to study. I would like to ask your permission to autopsy the alien cadavers retrieved from your last two field operations. I'm sure you would agree that if we're going to defeat the aliens, we must understand their physiology.
First, are complete, Commander. Engineering is awaiting approval for fabrication.
Darn.
Thank you, Commander. I will let you know when this research has been completed.
Engineering online.
It appears Dr. Shen's staff have finally figured out how to turn their machines on.
Commander to engineering. Commander.
Ah, Commander. I was wondering when you'd be stopping by. Welcome to engineering. Anything they can dream up in the research labs, we can build it here. Speaking of which, Dr. Vallen has just sent us some new schematics. With your approval, we will begin fabrication.
Build one.
Fabrication of the nanofiber vest is complete, Commander. It has been delivered to the armory.
Commander, to the barracks.
New items and weapons from engineering will always be delivered directly to the armory, Commander.
To the Situation Room. Commander, to the Situation Room.
Commander, the Council has requested a word.
Commander,
God!
I have identified a number of reports regarding alien involvement in the transportation and dispersal of an unknown substance.
I legitimately need to go help my mom with something.
It is imperative that you investigate this activity and determine the purpose of the alien material. We will transmit further details momentarily.
Sounds like we better get to it.
Mulder. God, you gotta be kidding me. I'm gonna see if I can save and quit once I'm in mission. I don't like doing that, but I think I'm gonna have to do that.
We have visual on the mission site. Setting down.
We're going to be putting down in Mexico for this mission.
Yes. Okay.